Hello, this is GamelliRevit.com. So let's continue with this Revit MEP 2012 and this fire protection creation. And this is video number 6 and is modifying pipe diameters. And one of the first things you need to understand is one thing is manually change the diameters or the height of the pipe. And another thing is using the tool, the appropriate tool for sizing. So in this exercise, I will use the tool for sizing fire protection pipes. So it's important also to use this tool because the tool calculates the diameter based on how many sprinklers head are you feeding from one portion of your system, and also because it's going to create a sprinkler sketch or report, and it's going to show the number of sprinklers per floor. So let's start this. First, this is the last file we started working in previous exercises of this tutorial. So notice we have a mechanical discipline, and as a sub-discipline we have fire protection and plumbing. So we are working on fire protection. So I'm gonna open level 2 because it's what we did in floor plan or in ceiling plan. I think it's better in ceiling plan. So because I opened floor plan before, I could close all hidden windows right here. Now I have ceiling plan and I have the system browser right here. And let's open a mechanical 3D view. Remember, because I'm in mechanical right here, so the 3D that I will double click here is the mechanical. That also is because it has selected that discipline, mechanical. If I change the discipline to something else, it will disappear from the mechanical menu right here. Let's see structure. Now it's gone from here, and actually we'll create a new one right here, structure, and this one. So let's put it back to mechanical and sub-discipline fire protection. So it's back in fire protection on the 3D menu, and this is the one. I think I'm going to hide the system browser right now. And that was in analyze, hide it. Now let's go to put side to side these two views using the tile command, which is if I add it to my quick bar, but also is right here under view tile right here. So notice when you highlight one and you hit the button, it brings to the left side, which is the first side. So whichever you want on the left side, touch it and hit the tile command. So I'm going to zoom a little bit just to show what we have here. This is the riser where everything starts, and right here is the two areas of the building. Remember this portion we did at the beginning, and this is the last part that we did in a couple different ways. Okay, now because the design specification says 1 inch diameter pipe will serve maximum 2 sprinklers. So because of that, the 1 inch diameter pipe will be the smallest pipe we are going to use. So at the beginning, we are going to make all pipes 1 inch diameter. And after that, we will see which pipe is serving more than two sprinklers, because we are saying 2 sprinklers max. So maybe these two pipes will be enough 1 inch diameter because serves 2 sprinklers. but probably from here to there is going to need obviously a bigger pipe because we'll serve all these four plus that plus here and plus these other sprinklers. So we will see as we go. So first let's get the whole thing selected in level 2. So what I would do is I would do just a complete window, and because I select all kind objects here, I go to my filters. I don't want elevation mark. I do want pipe fitting and pipes. I don't want the revealing, no spaces, no sprinklers heads at this point, and no view symbols. All I want is pipes and pipe fittings because it's what we are going to resize. So I remove the sprinklers here. Remember that is important. So now let's zoom on the 3D and remove this supply. Which is also this and the elbow. Remember I see it in single line because I'm here in medium level. I could be in 3D level, which is detail level, I'm sorry, and I could be in shaded mode, but in medium level is more quick everything. When you have a big project and you have it in detail level, the regen time is going to kill you. So I leave it in medium, and actually in this black and white mode, just hidden line instead of color shaded. All right, so I'm going to select previous because I was showing that I lose my selection, but again I have my selection all complete except this supply pipe that comes from the stairwell, and it was created, remember, when we dropped the base. All right, so I think I don't see the command right now, but I think I don't need to show. When we drop base, it create this supply. All right, so the selection is ready. So now as we have it selected and as we said, we will convert it to 1-inch pipe. So because we have multiple diameters right here, where it says diameter, it doesn't tell me what's the diameter. Normally, if you select one pipe or a series of pipes that has the same diameter, it will show you here. Obviously, since we have many of them, many different sizes, it cannot tell you in one. So now I click here, I either type 1-inch or I select one of the available possibilities. And look, it's doing the work, and now it shows all are 1-inch. So if I deselect, all of them are 1-inch, and by showing the detail mode, we can see all are 1-inch. So again, I will keep it in medium. Now let's make sure the whole system is connected. So I could put my mouse on tab and hit tab 1, 2. Actually, one of these 1, 2. Has to on top of one pipe, so it works on the supply. Until you hit 3 on the supply, it will work. But over here, if I hit 2 times tab 1, 2, it select the whole thing. I'm not sure right now why if you touch the supply, you have to hit 3 times the tab key in the keyboard. So again, I put my mouse. I don't touch nothing. I don't hit nothing. I just hold on tab and hit tab, and it tell me okay, now I click, that is your whole system. Okay, so we are well connected. Now I'm going to select my main branch on this view, which is ceiling view. I want to show an important button here, and because my display is too small, I don't see it, so I had to move my window and how to move my window right there. This This button press and drag. Okay, that's very important. Look, if it's selected and I'm going to do a window here, if I want to do a window like this here and accidentally touch the one object, in this case the linked model, and if accidentally have my mouse there and I try to do the window, look how I move one object to the right side. That's an accident, because I was trying to do this window, but instead of that window, I click and drag to do my window, and this thing happened. Now, if this press and drag is unchecked, which is my very first suggestion to everybody, if I is unchecked and I do the same thing by accident, I want to do my window, I click and drag, look what happened. I don't have the accident. The reason is press and drag means that you could move an object as soon as you press, you could drag it already, or move it, in other words, like I did right there. Now, I say I don't want press and drag automatic. I want to move something, I want press, which is selected, let it go. I'm not clicking my mouse anymore, and now drag. So now to move something or drag something, first I need to click, highlight it, let go my mouse, and then click and drag again. So it's one extra step, but it's more safe than with this. Click and drag is already moving, and many people made terrible mistakes having that button on. So my first suggestion, always turn it on check. No press and drag. That's the best suggestion somebody could tell you in Revit. I would even remove it from the whole software. I have never used it, and I hope people realize that's very dangerous button. I used to call it the dangerous button, by the way, just as a joke. So by saying that, we could now click and drag to select our main branch. So this pipe right here will be the main branch. So now, because I unchecked that button, I could click and drag here. Now, if you haven't locked or pinned your external reference, which is the architectural, I suggest before you do anything, let's select the whole linked file, which is this, the architectural file, but the whole file. Don't select only those spaces. Make sure you select the whole file. And I think if you are selecting the only one space and doesn't let you, I think if you hit tab on the edge of the wall, then it let you select the whole linked file. Now I'm going to pin it. That is the very first step after you attach the file. So, okay, I let it go. Now it's pin, so I cannot move it now. Again, my window, trying to select the main branch, which is this. Excuse me. Again, my filter, I want to make sure only pipes and fittings. Okay, so we are good. And I'm going to assume that I didn't select accidentally an extra piece, like I don't want this branch yet. If I select one of the other branches, I will remove it right now. So everything is good. So I'm going to look over here in the 3D. The same thing I was checking. Everything is good. I have two connectors here. I'm not gonna remove the second connector right now. So everything is good on my main. And if you look on plan view, my main is all the way from here up to here, and after that all kind branches. Now that will be 4 inches diameter. Now on this connector right here, because this pipe will be 6 inches as it used to be, let's take a look in detail view and shaded mode. Okay, everything looks fine because comes from a big pipe to smaller pipes, but over here looks very much wacky because it's a connector to a big pipe. And look, since all my connectors are now 4 inches pipe with 4 inches connector to smaller, it looks good. However, the one it goes to a bigger one, it doesn't. So let's select this connector right here, and I cannot filter out because the only thing it selected was connector, and I'm gonna make it 6 inches because the bigger pipe is 6 inches. Now apparently I did, let's see, I thought it was two connectors, but it is one connector. Okay, so we are good. And now it has this reduction here to 4 inches and reduction to 4 inches. So the only connector that I made it big as this pipe is this one, 6 inches. It makes sense because it goes to bigger to smaller one, so the connector, the fixture, the fitting piece, no fixture, fitting piece, has to be as the bigger one. And over here, everything else is as big as the bigger pipe, which is 4 inches, and it goes to 1 inch. So we are good. So the next video will be validating the pipe run geometry. And I'm going to stop the video here so it doesn't get too big. So revitunes.com. And let's continue in the next video with validating the pipe run geometry. In other words, verifying the calculation of the diameter. Revitunes.com, Gamelin.